first time. However, I need to make just a couple quick announcements about the Parish Bazaar.
Good morning and welcome to the first communion celebration of the Jubilee Year 2000. It is a very, very special day for the children who are here today. They look beautiful, each and every one of them, on the outside, and they are even more beautiful on the inside. They have made it to this day and to care to welcome Jesus as their best friend. They have talked about him, they have learned about him, and they know who he is, and they know today when they come forward that they will be having him in their lives and in their hearts forever, and they will be sharing him with you in every single thing they do. They have been waiting, and they have now waited long enough. Children, if you will please stand and rise, get in order two by two, and come forward. We will begin this celebration. Thank you. The grace and peace of the risen Christ be with all of you. As we gather here on this beautiful spring day, we pause and recognize
Lord Jesus, you came to gather the nations into the peace of God's kingdom. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You come in word and sacrament to strengthen us in holiness. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You will come in glory with salvation for your people. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. We praise our God together as we say, glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, Heavenly King, Almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit and the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. God our Father, may we look forward with hope to our resurrection, for you have made us your sons and daughters and restored the joy of our youth. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated now for the sacred scripture readings.
Peter said to the people, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob, the God of our fathers has glorified his servant Jesus, whom you handed over and denied in Pilate's presence when he had decided to release you. You denied the holy and righteous one and asked that a murderer be released to you. The author of life you put to death, but God raised him from the dead. Of this we are witnesses. Now I know, brothers, that you acted out of ignorance, just as your leaders did. But God has thus brought to fulfillment what he had announced beforehand through the mouth of all the prophets that his Christ would suffer. Repent, therefore, and be converted that your sins may be wiped away. Word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord, let your faith face shine upon us.
Lord, let your faith shine upon us.
When I call, answer me. O my just God, you who pity me when I am in distress, have pity on me and hear my prayer.
Lord, let your faith shine on us.
Know that the Lord does wonders for his faithful ones. The Lord will hear me when I call upon him.
Lord, let your face shine on us.
O Lord, let the light of your countenance shine upon us. You put gladness into my heart.
Lord, let your face shine on us.
As soon as I lie down, I fall peacefully asleep. For you alone, O Lord, bring security to my dwelling.
Lord, let your face shine on us.
A reading from the first letter of St. John. My children, I am writing this to you so that you may not commit sin. But if anyone does sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ, the righteous one. He is expiation for our sins, but not for our sins only, but for those of the whole world. The way we may be sure that we know him is to keep his commandments. Those who say, I know him, but do not keep his commandments are liars, and the truth is not in them. But whoever keeps his word, the love of God, is truly perfected in him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
how Jesus was made known to them in the breaking of the bread. While they were still speaking about this, he stood in their midst and said to them, "Peace be with you." But they were startled and terrified and thought they were seeing a ghost. Then he said to them, "Why are you troubled? And why do questions arise in your hearts? Look at my hands and my feet, that it is I myself. Touch me and see, because a ghost does not have flesh and bones, as you can see I have." And as he said this, he showed them his hands and his feet. While they were still incredulous for joy and were amazed, he asked them, "Have you anything here to eat?" They gave him a piece of baked fish. He took it and ate it in front of them. He said to them, "These are my words that I spoke to you while I was still with you, that everything written about me in the law of Moses and in the prophets and Psalms must be fulfilled." Then he opened their minds to understand the scriptures. And he said to them, "Thus it is written that the Christ would suffer and rise from the dead on the third day, and that repentance for the forgiveness of sins would be preached in his name to all the nations, beginning from Jerusalem. You are witnesses of these things." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Well, boys and girls, you have never looked better. You are so beautiful today and so handsome, I can't believe it, but you really look beautiful, wonderful. I just want to ask you a couple of questions today. The thing I noticed when I came into church this morning to finish getting ready for First Communion, I noticed your beautiful pew markers, and I hope everyone has a chance to look at these before they're taken down. Each child made a special First Communion pew marker to designate their pew. And these are the most beautiful ones I have ever seen. They're incredible. This one even looks like a pillow or a cushion of some kind. And there's one down in the front that has clay. It's made out of clay. I would like to be this talented. This is incredible. Now these pew markers, well, this one right here. Now these pew markers have special emblems on them. Like I see, well, what do I see on the pew markers? What are those pictures of? Does anyone know? What's on the pew marker? Yes, here? A chalice. Okay, a chalice is on the pew marker. What else? Yes. Bread. Okay, bread. I see bread on there.
Okay, yes.
Wheat.
Okay, anything else?
Yeah, no. And grapes. Okay, very good. Those seem to be important on each of the pictures. Now, why do you think those four things are on the picture? Why do we have wheat, bread, grapes, and a chalice? Why are those things there? Yes. Okay, that's what Jesus ate at the Last Supper. Very good. At the Last Supper, Jesus gathered together his friends, and he had a special meal called the Passover meal. And at the Passover meal, he had wine, and he had special bread, and he had this wonderful meal at the Last Supper. And then what else did he do at the Last Supper? What happened at the Last Supper? Do you remember? What happened at the Last Supper? Okay, very, very good. John said he took the bread and he broke it. And he said to his friends, and he said to everyone, he said, "This is my body, which is broken for you." Okay, beautiful. And then what did he do with the drink, with the wine? What did he do there? Yes. He shared it. Okay, good. Then he shared the wine too. So he took the bread and he shared it, and then he took the wine and he shared it too. And that's exactly what happens at every single Mass, boys and girls. The priest takes the bread, and he takes the wine, and he speaks the very words that Jesus spoke. And he says, "This is my body, and this is my blood." And then what does he do? He shares it. He shares it. And that's exactly what happens today. For the very first time, you, boys and girls, are going to share in the Eucharist. share in the body and the blood of Jesus. And this is why this is a very special day for all of you and for your families. For all of St. Mary's Church, this is a special day. This is one of the highlights of our whole year. This is one of the most special days in the whole life of our church to have our First Communion boys and girls receive the Eucharist for the first time. So we, your family and your friends, we pray that you will really open your heart to Jesus today. Because every time you come here to St. Mary's now, you can receive the Eucharist with your family, with your friends, with all the rest of us. So today starts a whole new day for you, a whole new period for you when you can come forward and receive the Eucharist. So we pray that you will come here often. We pray that you will come here often with your family and that you will come to the Lord's table, because that's what the poster for the banner says. What does the banner read? Can any second grader read the banner that's up here to my left over here? Who can read that? Can you read it, Alex?
It says,
okay, very good, Alex. Welcome to the table of the Lord. And that's exactly what you're doing today. You're going to be there with Jesus at the table, and you're going to be coming forward to the Lord's table to receive Eucharist. You're not just receiving bread, you're not just receiving wine, you're receiving the body and the blood of Christ. And so, boys and girls, we pray that this will be a special day for you, and we pray that you will come here often to be with us around the table of the Lord as we gather here every Sunday to celebrate Eucharist and to celebrate the Lord's Day. Now we stand and we pray for all of our needs. We pray for our boys and girls and for all of our parish.
The response will be, Risen Lord, hear our prayer. That the peace given to the early disciples will come to troubled areas of our world, we pray to the Lord.
Risen Lord, hear our prayer.
That the newly baptized and those recently received into the church may grow in holiness, we pray to the Lord.
Risen Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may be witnesses to the risen Lord in our homes, at school, at our work, we pray to the Lord.
Risen Lord, hear our prayer.
That young people may pray seriously for the wisdom to know to what vocation the Lord is calling them, we pray to the Lord.
Risen Lord, hear our prayer.
That our children, receiving First Holy Communion for their first time this weekend, will open their hearts to Jesus and encounter him often at the table of the Lord, we pray to the Lord.
Risen Lord, hear our prayer. And we pray for all of our deceased loved ones. In a special way today, we pray for Cardinal John O'Connor, who died this week. And we also pray for Leo Antel, a member of this parish who died this morning. The Lord will grant him eternal rest. Lord God, we pray for these prayers today. Please bless us and bless our First Communion class, for we can do nothing without you. We have prayed in Jesus' name. He is our Lord and our Savior forever and ever. Amen.
Thank you.
acceptable to God the Almighty Father. Lord, receive these gifts from your church. May the great joy that you give us come to perfection in heaven. Grant this through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Father, all-powerful and ever-living God, we do well always and everywhere to give you thanks through Jesus Christ our Lord. We praise you with greater joy than ever in this Easter season when Christ became our paschal sacrifice. He has made us children of the light, rising to new and everlasting life. He has opened the gates of heaven to receive his faithful people. His death is our ransom from death. His resurrection is our rising to life. The joy of the resurrection renews the whole world, while the choirs of heaven sing forever to your glory.
Thank you.
We remember his death and resurrection. Father in heaven, accept us together with your beloved Son. He willingly died for us, but you raised him to life again. Jesus now lives with you in glory, but he is also here on earth among us. One day he will come in glory, and in his kingdom there will be no more suffering, no more tears, and no more sadness. Father in heaven, you have called us to receive the body and the blood of Christ at this table, and to be filled with the joy of the Holy Spirit. Through this sacred meal, give us strength to please you more and more. Lord our God, remember John Paul, our Pope, Gerald, our Bishop, and all other bishops. Help all who follow Jesus to work for peace and to bring happiness to others. Finally, bring us all at last, together with Mary, the Mother of God, and all the saints, to live with you and to be one with Christ in heaven. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Thank you.
This is Jesus, the Lamb of God, who invites us today to come to his table. Happy are those invited to this banquet. Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word, and I shall be.
marks 200 years since the birth of John Brown, who kicked off the Civil War, the great struggle to free black men, women, and little children. And so I've spent the weekend in the company of some of America's best educated and best organized black men and women. And I fell asleep last night thinking about what their eyes have seen and what they've accomplished. And I woke up this morning thinking about what Jesus accomplished with just 12 good people. And then I thought, I wonder what he will accomplish with this first communion class. And so this morning before Mass, God made me write down this little song for them. When you grow up, will you join the freedom fight? Will you be the one who ends the terror in the night? When you grow into a woman or a man, remember those who hunger and take their hand. When you grow up, will you sing with me? Will you sing the songs that set all people free? Raise up your voice and sing for what's right. Sing for all the people who are frightened in the night. When you grow up, will you walk with me? Will you walk with me for peace and dignity? Stand and defend our people's rights. Know that God himself will give you the might. When you grow up, will you join the freedom fight? Will you be the one who ends the terror in the night? When you grow into a woman or a man, remember those who hunger and take their hand. When you grow up,
Taylor Kelsey.
Travis Eterno. Eric Anjanski. Casey Neno. Jonathan Goldberg. Brooke Beacorn. Joshua Fennell. Ivory Racine. Brandy Rivers. Nicholas Roberts. Matthew Jacob. Paige Timmons. And Joshua Shabbat. Our first community class for the year 2000. Let us stand for our celebration. Lord, look on your people and our children with kindness, and by these Easter mysteries, bring us to the glory of the resurrection. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Now, all of this would not be possible without many, many people working very hard to bring all of this together. And I'd like to just name a few names, although I don't like to do that because oftentimes I forget people. But I would like to thank in a special way Mrs. Ann Morgan, who coordinates our sacramental programs here at St. Mary's Parish. Jonathan has some flowers for Mrs. Morgan. And Brooke Beacorn has some flowers for Mrs. Donna Giro, who is our second grade Sunday morning religion. Sister Juliana, our principal at St. Mary's Academy, who taught the second graders at the school when their teacher went out on maternity leave. Thank you, sister. To those who helped today, Mrs. Gloria Graham, Mrs. Cecile Filion, Ms. Kathy K.A., all of those who assisted in any way, thank you very, very much. Immediately following the procession, our youngsters will come back here into the sanctuary for a group photograph, and please take as many photographs as you want. We're going to process down the main aisle, and then they're going to come back by way of the side aisle into the sanctuary for photographs. Thank you. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you and keep you always, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Our celebration has ended. Go in peace, love, serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.